I'm back, niggas. I'm back. Had a bunch of baseball games, had me in motherfucking 130 degrees. But I'm back, man. Salute to everybody. East Coast, West Coast, Midwest, Las Vegas, Alphabet City. You already know what the fuck. CWN Sports, the Al York Sports Show. We will be off this Sunday. We'd like to, you know, basically wish all of y'all a happy Thanksgiving weekend. From now, tomorrow, all the way to Sunday. Enjoy with your family. Yeah, we're going to shut it down this week due to the fact of that. You know, but you know I'm going to keep it moving, man. I'm Mr. Content, man. I'm going to always throw out some type of content, man. Salute to everybody, the panel, the round table. Noah Parker, Will, the money line guy, Justin Yu, Crystal Lynn, everybody, man. Everybody, man. Hot Wheels, salute to everybody, man. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to get back to you on that. Now on sports discussions, my boy Dwayne Beeman, a.k.a. Mr. Stop Running, is going to have a fight in CSU Wolston Center, June 22nd, a CBS sports bout. Now, my dude, y'all got to start saluting my dude, man. You know what I'm saying? He been keeping it funky, man. He 33 years young, man. Don't get it twisted, man. He in better shape than a bunch of 19, 20-year-olds. Trust me, man. This nigga got boxes. He got razor blades and fucking boxes. I don't know what the fuck he's doing, but my dude's the truth. I'm here to back him up. I had him since day one. He knows I've been behind his back since day one, because that's how real niggas do. When I met the nigga and I seen the type of dude he was humble, hardworking, appreciative. And not only that, man, he represented my Al York sports shit in the fucking ring, man. I mean, how much love can a nigga get, man? That's why I fucks with him all day, every day. He's 16-1-1 with 11 Ks, KOs. I said Ks like it's baseball. KOs, 11 KOs, 16-1-1. He's fighting Froland Salador, who's 33 losses, one draw, a.k.a. the sniper. And my boy is a.k.a. Mr. Stop Running. So you got Stop Running versus the sniper. It should be very interesting. But my man, yo, Beeman, man, like I said, if you knock him out, you ain't got to worry about the judges. That's the whole game plan. We knocking niggas out. But, you know, we giving niggas to the fourth, sixth round. You wear them down like you do with them hard blows to the bodies. Get them the fuck out of there. Next subject, we going to NBA. Yesterday, big game at Staples Center. Highly anticipated. You know, people thought that, you know, since the Clippers came back the other night, DeMarcus Cousins was out, that Dub Nation was going to come in flat, like some flat Pepsi. Wasn't happening, man. These guys came in that building, out the gate, went up like 73-52 at half. They've been blowing them basically every half. And Clippers came back one game, but they didn't come back, you know, yesterday or game one. And if I'm a betting man, I'll take the Clippers the next game. Hopefully you can get 9-10 points. I think the Clippers come within that number. Because they have to really show up. They got to show up out the gate. They can't let Dub Nation every game go up 20. I think Doc Rivers has stopped that. But like I said, they got lit up in Staples Center yesterday. Durant dropped 38. Curry 21. Thompson 12. And for the Clippers, you know, you had Zubac with 18. Lou Williams 16. Harrell and Jermichael Green had 15 apiece. But Clippers were really never in the game. Blowout for Dub Nation. Now, let's go to the series that I said that I like the dog. I've been liking the dog. That's the Denver Nuggets, two-seeded versus seven-seeded San Antonio Spurs. Spurs are showing them why they're going to win this series, because they got the veterans. They've been there. Popovich know how to coach this type of basketball. And Denver's just like a team that got a bunch of good players but never been through it. You got to go through this, like, playoff shit to understand what the fuck it is. You just can't step in the playoffs, B. It's just like if you're a fighting dude, you knocking niggas out on your block. Now you get to a platform where you got dudes just like you. And you just can't knock everybody out. You gotta learn how to box, outbox dudes. And that's what's happening now. You know, Denver's trying to go up and down the court like they did all season. San Antonio's slowing that ass up, man. And they got a lot of crafty veterans, like I said, from Aldridge, DeRozan, Patty Mills, Bellinelli. They got the young boy White who's stepping up. And I'm going to take, you know, I'm going to take the Spurs to close them out. I don't know how they're going to beat them. If it's going to be six games, seven games. I got the Spurs. But all the Spurs got to do is basically they got to win this game four to go up 3-1. You don't want to go 2-2 back to the Pepsi Center. Then you give them life and then they steal the series from you. You want to close these guys out. You want to win the next game and then close them out in the next two games. Salute to the Spurs and Popovich. This series here is disturbing. Brooklyn goes to Philadelphia, does them dirty game one. Philly came back game two as anticipated. You know, 3-6, you know, big favorites. And I gave out Sixers game two. I said they would win easy and they did. I didn't have a judge. I didn't have a pick for game three. I knew it could have went either way. I do like the Nets though to win the series, so I would predict they would have won that game. But they can, you know, they can still come back. You know, win the next game they play, which is tomorrow, tie up the series. They already proved they can win at Philly. You know, the thing is, Philly let them up in the second half yesterday without Embiid, and that was kind of sad because you ain't got your best player and you lit him up. You know, it ain't like Dub Nation where Cousins is out. Cousins is not the best player. Cousins 1 of 4. Embiid is basically the Sixers' best player. Not all-around player, but he's their best player. He's the big man. He scores from inside, get a jump shot. He got defense. Joel Embiid is the best player on the Sixers, in my opinion. And they beat him cleanly without him. Now, I don't know if the, you know, the Nets were caught off guard. I'm not going to make no excuses. I just think Sixers played a lot better game. Led by Ben Simmons, who dropped 31. Tobias Harris stepped up 29. J.J. Redick 26. Jimmy Buckets 16. And for the Nets, D'Angelo Russell, who's having a great series, dropped 26. Caris LeVert dropped 26. And Jared Allen and Spencer Dinwiddie both dropped 15 for the Nets. But Nets have to win game four. Tie it up because I know they can win one in Philly. But you got to tie it up. You can't go down 3-1. You go down 3-1. Series Sixers. Now that's the other underdog. I like to come out as an underdog out the series because I picked a few dogs, you know what I'm saying? And in other news, in NFL schedules came out the other day. The one I'm really interested in is September 5th. Packers play at Bears, opening night, Thursday night game, and the Sunday night game is going to be Pittsburgh Steelers at New England. So NFL already hitting them with the schedules, getting it out there. You know, kind of like teasing people with the football thing. We got the draft coming up. Everybody know where Murray or want to know where Murray going to wind up at. Seattle already locked theirs with Russell Wilson. So whatever people was thinking about that is dead. Seattle locked him up for 4 years. Like I said, he signed for 4 years, 140, 35 M's a year, $65 million signing bonus. So like I said, guys, I'm going to make this quick and simple. Basically like a touch-up video just to keep y'all, you know, to keep y'all know that I'm still here, but it's actually like a weekend off. It should be a weekend off, but like I said, I'm Mr. Content. I gotta give y'all something, man, and this is something I'm giving y'all, you know what I mean? No, this Sunday, we'll be back next Sunday. You know, my individual videos is out twice a week. I'll be back Tuesday with another individual. Salute to CWN Sports. Like I said, you want to go to the podcast, you go to AYSS.CWNSports.com. You get all the shows on that. You want to go to the YouTube, you go to Al York Sports. Subscribe on YouTube, Twitter, Al York Sports, Instagram, Al York Sports, Facebook, Al York or Al York Sports. I got crazy content. Niggas know I do not play around with this. I got content flooded. So y'all already know I stay working. I stay on my grind. It doesn't matter what the fuck I'm in. I'm going to get y'all some content, man. That's what I have to do. That's what's in my mind. I got to give y'all that. If I want to keep y'all dudes supporting me, looking into my shit, believing in me, I got to give y'all what I got to give y'all. And with that, thank you, people. Thanks, everybody, to continuing to, like, you know, get involved in my movement, support my movement. I promise you guys, I will not let y'all down, man. Let me be the example for y'all, man. I'm telling you, man, I want to take heads off, do whatever it takes, prove my situation. 40 year plus is doing this. I'm ready for whatever, man. And with that, y'all keep your head out, your sports. Love y'all motherfuckers. Let's get it.